I will be doing another conversation with somebody here. Thanks for sitting next to me, Funkhauser. Here's two brothers that don't get along occasionally. Hola, cis.
Maybe I don't really want to know how you got engrossed, 'cause I just want to fly. Lately, did you ever feel the pain in the morning rain? Don't shoot to the bone. Maybe I just wanna fly, wanna live but don't wanna die. Maybe I just wanna breathe. Maybe I just don't believe. Maybe you're the same as me. We see things I'll never see. You and I are gonna be forever. I said maybe.
I'm feeling right, I feel like I never could. You got me shouting through my neighborhood. Oh, cause baby, I'm feeling good. I see the world in full color, blue skies and bright sunsets. My world exploded after we first met. Oh, and I'm living with no regrets. You got me living a good life. Oh, we're putting up a good fight. It's like we're soaking up the sunlight. Oh, and baby, I'm feeling right. You got me living a good life. Oh, we're putting up a good fight. It's like we're soaking up the sunlight. Oh, and baby, I'm feeling right.
Feeling right, feeling right.
We'll spread the word, we'll spread the light. You got me hearing a fashionable sound. I'm flowing 10 feet above the ground. We got our hopes, we got our dreams, we can do anything. Cause this is real, it ain't make-believe. Oh, and baby, we've been set free. You got me living a good life. Oh, we're putting up a good fight. It's like we're soaking up the sunlight. Baby, I'm feeling right. You got me living a good life. Oh, we're putting up a good fight. It's like we're soaking up the sunlight. Oh, baby, I'm feeling right. Oh, you got me feeling right. Oh, you got me feeling bold.
The good life.
I think you got me so. I ain't returning to my old.
The good life. Oh, da 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 da.
We ain't ever giving up.
Is this Oklahoma's Matt Stansberry?
This is him.
Hi, it's Funkhauser. You're sitting next to me. It's Funkhauser sitting next to you. How are you? Are you living that good life?
I am. Glad to be sitting next to you.
Are you in Oklahoma now?
I am. I'm in Oklahoma City, and the weather is actually incredible today. It's about 83 degrees, 82, somewhere around there. Just had lunch out on the patio. It's a really nice day, actually.
Wow. Well, we're getting like a heat wave here. And it's if you were here, you would write a similar song about it, I'm sure.
I'm sure I would.
So let's go back all the way to the beginning with Matt Stansberry and start at the roots. I mean, I hear your accent there. So you're probably born and raised in Oklahoma. Where did you start there?
Love it. You know, I don't hear that I have an accent very often, but I guess that I do. I love hearing that. It cracks me up. Yeah, you know, it's everybody that, you know, you never realize that you have one, but, yeah, so I was born in Western Oklahoma, a smaller town called Elk City. It's about 2 hours west of Oklahoma City, but majority of my life I've grown up in the Oklahoma City area. And so, yeah, I'm a Okie through and through.
Okay. So did you grow up on a farm, or when did you pick up a guitar? What's the,
no farm life, you know, it was a little more urban than that, but, but yeah, I started playing. So my family, there's just music in my family. So my great grandfather, he ran in the land run, but prior to that, he was traveling the country, like teaching music schools and stuff. And then my grandfather was a bluegrass fiddle player.
Oh, okay.
My dad's a singer songwriter and guitar player.
This is a family business, then, you're saying?
Kind of, but like they never really pushed it on me. I would just kind of thought it was their thing, and I just would watch them play, and I wasn't really grown up. I was always into art and stuff, and then around middle school, for some reason, I don't even remember what got me into it, but I got really into guitar. And
you don't remember? You don't remember, like, what was the first song that you played on a guitar that you learned how to play? Do you remember that?
Well, what I would do is, so this is really interesting. At the time, I was in orchestra, like, playing violin in school.
Uh-huh.
And so what I would do is I would know, it's just kind of a really, really weird way to learn guitar. because I never had any formal lessons, but I would know what the melody was supposed to sound like on the violin. So I would look at that music and I would figure out where those notes were on the guitar. So I learned, I started off with like really simple, just like it could be Happy Birthday or Mary Had a Little Lamb or just something really simple single note. But I would figure out the notes on the guitar by what I learned in violin, which it's really kind of a...
I get it. I mean, I played the cello when I was younger, and I don't know how to play the guitar or anything, but I see what you're saying when you can look at music and then play it on another thing. That's so Happy Birthday then. That's great. Is that the song?
Yeah, so that kind of got me going, and then I started writing songs like almost instantaneously. So as soon as I started learning like chords and guitar ideas, I wrote as many songs as I did learn other people's songs. So I've just kind of always been, they all sucked, of course, but I mean, I was trying to write, I guess. It was just part of who I am, I guess.
Everyone has a beginning, you know?
Right.
All right. Well, September, you have a new album coming out, right? You have two albums actually. And, why are you releasing so much music all at once? Are you bum rushing the people with all of the songs? I mean, what's the story?
I mean, this is one of those things too, like it wasn't super planned originally. I had all this extra material that I liked, but I didn't really see it as stuff that was like romance-ish. So, but I wanted to do it and I thought it would make sense. So I started working on it. And as I started working on these demos, it just kind of clicked. I was like, every song I was like, man, this would be cool if this had just trumpet, or this had just Myra singing, or this. So it kind of snowballed in this idea of like being a solo album where I featured band members. And so it's really kind of unique that way, where it's not really just a solo record and just a romance record. There's some bleed over, and the bleed over is that romance members are featured on almost every track.
Right. Okay. So let me ask you, do you want to beat up Ray LaMontagne, or is he your buddy?
You know, I've actually met Ray one time. I went to the Grammys of, I don't know what year it was, 2011 maybe. Mm-hmm. And I met him, and he was a super nice guy. And, so I would say we're not friends because I don't know the guy, but, very well, other than meeting him one time, but I would like to say we're friends, you know, I don't want to beat the guy up.
Right. Okay, good. Awesome. So you're on the pro side. That's good. Me too. All right. Have you done some traveling? I'm sure you've toured a lot. Where was the best place that you've been that you had the most fun at?
That's tough to say.
Besides Oklahoma, because anytime you play a hometown show, all the people come down, and that's always fun. But like,
yeah, hometown shows are fun. So the most fun I've ever had playing anywhere was Japan. I went years ago. And this is before the romance and all that stuff. We did like 7 shows in 9 days nine shows in 7 days. I think it's backwards, but that was probably the most incredible experience I've had musically, just on all and personally and socially and all that. I mean, it was incredible.
Wow. Yeah. Cool. Everybody singing your songs, jumping around. And it's a whole other country with different money.
Yeah, it's very interesting like that. I mean, it was kind of surreal. They're super fun people.
So, okay, so the romance started happening at what point in time there?
It started kind of coming together in 2011, and then we released our first record in 2012. So it was a short time frame. And here's the interesting thing. So we never played a show together before we made that record, and I didn't even know the singers on it or most of the horn players. Like, we had hired them as session people, like, and it was really not supposed to be anything more than a one-off project. And it didn't even have a name. It was just going to be my solo record. And then it's kind of evolved because everybody was like, hey, if you want to play this out live, I want to be in it. So I was like, oh, this could be like a band, you know? So, everything happens totally out of order.
Wow. Yeah. That's incredible. So did they sing, and then you're like, what's your name over there? You there with the voice.
It wasn't that extreme, but pretty much.
Did you ever have to change like band members along the way? Has there ever been some like additions or subtractions, or do you keep the same crew?
Yeah. So it's kind of a little bit of all that. So up at the 10 piece, currently we're a 9 piece band. We have like core band members right now, but just with the amount of shows we do and everybody's schedules and different things, we have subs every now and then, or we may be in Kansas City and have a Kansas City trumpet player join us. So it's kind of like a core group, but there is a little bit of rotating cast.
And you still highlight singers, right? In your shows, you said?
Yeah. So my brother plays rhythm guitar and sings. And then Myra Beasley, she does all the, you know, powerhouse, more gospel soul vocal work in the group. And I feel like my job is to sort of like tell the story of the song. So I kind of sing it down the middle a little bit. And then those two kind of put all the fun bells and whistles on it.
Well, okay. So let's run down what we have learned. Okay. So not only are you an excellent violin player, you also have found the romance, and we've got an arsenal of music coming out. What do you want to do next?
You know, I don't get asked that a ton, but I actually am working. I know we're about to release this album, but I'm already working on the next idea. And if I had to decide that it could totally change, but if I had to decide a day based on what this music sounded like, I'd kind of like to do like have the romance, but include some strings or some orchestra or something along those lines.
All right.
Uh-huh. So there may be something in the works that we do along those lines, at least as a one-off project. I think that's, if things go to plan or not, they usually go not to plan, but if they just go the same trajectory they're on now, that may be the next thing we do.
Whoa, dude. Well, do you have plans to conquer the West Coast, particularly Southern California? So, you know, I can particularly see you.
You know, I would love to. We don't have anything on the books right now. We've been really pushing hard for this Midwest, Southwest, you know, from South Texas to Chicago and east.
At this point, you could do some benefit shows, you know, from Hurricane Harvey.
Oh yeah. We're talking about some ideas there, if there's something we can do. So we've been putting our heads together. If there's, you know, whether it's to raise funds here for a benefit in Oklahoma City, we're in discussions about stuff right now. We just haven't figured out how we can play a role yet.
Wow. Okay. All right. Well, Matt Stansberry and the Romance, I thank you for being next to us today. And one last thing before we go, usually we ask people, because this is a driving show, we're like getting somewhere. And while you're driving on the road, is there something that you listen to or a particular song or practice that you use while you're trying to de-stress from getting from here to there?
You know, I'm a big podcast listener, so I listen to a lot of podcasts.
Ooh, what's your favorite one?
Right now I'm listening to The Art of Charm. I'm into that one right now.
The Art of Charm.
They just had a good episode with Charlemagne the God, the radio.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I met that guy a couple times. He's nice, friendly.
Yeah, he's kind of an outspoken guy. He's cool. I enjoyed some of his thoughts and processes, and so I learned a little bit there yesterday. So yeah, I'm a podcaster.
Great. Yeah, the time just flies when somebody's talking to you. That's why we're here, sitting next to each other. All right, Matt Stansberry. Thanks. So, okay, one more thing before we bail. Can you request a song? Like, what's your favorite song out there that we can jam out to? I mean, we're going to play your songs, of course, but, like, is there a song that we could play in between that gives you some juice there in Oklahoma?
Yeah, I'm still listening. This song's a few years old, but it's a good upbeat song. I think over time it may be an underground classic. Wolfpack, Back Pocket.
Look at you. That's an easy one. All right, let's wrap it up here. Funkhauser sitting next to you with Matt Stansberry and The Romance. This one's Heartbreaker. Thank you for being next to us here. And we'll see you next time.
You better go and ask her, 'cause she gon' tell you that he's the real dude. And he could be real cool, but he don't mind being rude. You're gonna feel your heart break, he'll break your heart. You're gonna feel your heart break, he's gonna break your heart. You're gonna feel your heart break, your heart break. You're gonna feel your heart break, he's gonna break your heart. In his trance, make you feel the romance. He's got you right where you're at, 'cause baby he's on the attack. And he gon' make his move. Well, can't you see he's on the prowl? And it's about to get real loud, 'cause baby it's going down. You're gonna feel your heartbreak, he'll break your heart. You're gonna feel your heartbreak, he's gonna break your heart. Yes, you're gonna feel your heartbreak, your heart. Feel your heartbreak, he's gonna break your heart. She's the heartbreaker, love taker. Well, hey, before she break you, you better background check her. It's just between you and me. Well, she got a history, and she could be real mean, 'cause she don't mind being queen. You're gonna feel your heartbreak, she'll break your heart. You're gonna feel your heartbreak, she gonna break your heart. She gonna feel your heartbreak, your heartbreak. You're gonna feel your heartbreak, she gonna break your heart. Got you in her trance, make you feel the romance. She got you right where you're at, 'cause baby she's on the attack. She gon' make a move. Well, can't you see she's on the prowl? And it's about to get real loud, 'cause baby, it's going down. You're gonna feel your heartbreak, she'll break your heart. You're gonna feel your heartbreak, she gon' break your heart. She gon' feel your heartbreak, your heartbreak. You're gonna feel your heartbreak, she gon' break your heart. Didn't warn ya.